and, you know, equality to equity of services, right? And so, you know, I had this passion and, you know, this culmination of all these great ideas, and I saw that I wanted to create events in my experience. And so now, given the question that I posed is, what's my summer strategy? I culminated this event called Vibrant Communities. And it was really the strategy that I'm working with many organizations, working with a lot of artists, and cultivating a lot of the resident, you know, momentum of, right, there's just this really huge momentum in advocacy and why these issues are really important. So how do we create an event really that's really genuine to the Valley, and then that's for the people by the people? And I think prior to that, I might have also had my experience is that I also contracted with Comic-Con Palm Springs last year, right? And so that was really my own first take at, you know, help co-producing things on the local level. So given that experience, I took it up a notch and really wanted to be present in where art and culture really needed to thrive. And we already know there's a huge momentum, right, with, you know, Coachella Fest and all these other great events that happen in the East Valley, but, right? One thing that really strikes the people, not just me, but the people of the East Valley, is that equity of access to arts and culture, right? And you're saying that they're, you know, you're having this great affluent production and it's great and beautiful for the people that can afford it. And needless to say, the people that are residents of the East Valley having to experience, you know, this production at this high level and never being able to participate really does something for, you know, the development in the East Valley. So we're and not knocking down on like any of, you know, Golden Voices efforts. You know, they're really great stakeholder in what they do, but really I've seen that there's a lot of attempts, right, to attain that momentum that Coachella Fest is bringing. And so, you know, kind of in the regards, you know, and watching, you know, different programs and different organizations, you know, have their own take. To me, what Vibrant Communities is to really cultivate, like I said, the advocacy and the picture of not just what our work in California Partnership is, but what the narrative has been set in the East Valley, right? That our communities in the East Valley, because of so many great organizations and so many great people that have, you know, influenced the development of the East Valley, have made our communities vibrant. And so that's how it really came out with Vibrant Communities. And so it's really to recognize, you know, not just the work that we're doing, but our partners, the stories of our residents, and, you know, culminate into an artistic way that can really be culturally, what we say, culturally competent to the places that we're in. And so that's yet to still be developed, but it essentially, from afar, you know, it still sounds very damning. And so it's a two-component fundraiser. It's a dinner and a what we're calling culture performances, right? So I have within my network a really great talent. From, you know, a performer from New York, and Madi D. Great, you know, she's also inspired in her work. We have Rascahuele, which is a Spanish ska reggae band from LA, and we have Reitner, who I'm sure some of you guys may heard. He's a local band, and then we have what I'm liking, my source preference is EDM music, but the DJ's from Romania, right? And so they all like these different aspects of, you know, breaking, you know, making culturally or making music more culturally relevant to this great space and what we're calling back to community. So it's been an awesome journey. Continue to, you know, work on the issues at hand with, you know, health and human services, but also also seeing the need that, right, that, you know, of art really complementing, you know, our messaging. And, you know, there's so many intersectional paths that, you know, we all cross in our work here, right? But really what we're saying is that the neutral platform to really culminate all this great spaces in the arts and culture. So I'm really glad to be here. Like, I'm definitely available to, you know, help out and continue to grow, you know, any efforts and, you know, in the community.